The top shelf is intended to be a storage unit that mounts on top of a standard freestanding range. It is manufactured in several different sizes, 20, 24, and 30 inch, white and black. As you can see in the picture here, it would mount directly on top of the stove with no additional fasteners. There are a couple limitations on where it will not work. The range that you plan to use it on should have some type of raised edge on the top. And that is so when the top shelf is put in place, that the ledge on the top shelf has something to rest on and hold in place with. So if your particular range does not have some type of raised edge, it probably isn't a good application. The other time that the top shelf can be a problem is if the opening for the range is so tight that this edge of the top shelf will not fit down alongside the range. It probably would be a problem as well. And then the other is if you have controls that are on the back of the range here and they are mounted higher than 10.5 inches. They would be interfere with the deflector of the top shelf and would be difficult to see. Other than that, the top shelf will fit on just about any range. It can handle up to 75 pounds, which means it's ideal for a microwave, but you can also put cookbooks, salt and pepper shakers, and any utensils that you need. I'm going to describe how to assemble the top shelf product. It comes generally in a box similar to this. And the first thing you want to do, save time and maybe trouble, is to take a look at the end of the box and make sure that what you purchased will fit your range. For starters, if you've got a 30-inch wide range, you want to make sure that the top shelf you have is for a 30-inch product, and it'll be darkened out for the model that you have. There's 30, there's 24, and then 20. The other thing you want to look at is that if you have a white range, obviously you want a white top shelf, so you want to make sure that they cross through the W for white or the B for black, depending on which you like to have. Now, assuming that it is what you plan to use, go ahead and cut it open. And I've already done that and set the parts out on the table here for assembly purposes. It's good to do just a basic inventory and make sure all the parts that you expect to be in the package are here. It comes with a top cap, which will be the top part of the top shelf. A deflector, which will go on the underside of the top shelf. One left and one right top shelf end. And four tenoring clips. Six sheet metal screws, six hex kept nuts, and six machine screws, and one instruction manual. And finally, one safety cable to tie a microwave to. Assuming you have all the pieces, let's go ahead and put this top shelf together. We'll start by removing the plastic from the deflector. You want to find an edge where you can peel the plastic off and just peel it off of the unit and set it aside. Now that we've peeled the plastic off of the deflector, you want to set the parts on the table with the top panel of the top shelf sitting with the flanges up on the table with this small hole facing to the left in front of you. Take the deflector and set it inside the top panel. Take the clips that were provided with the unit and put one clip on each of the two holes on the right hand side of the deflector with the flat side of the clip facing up. Do the same thing with the other side. Now we're going to set the deflector inside the top of the top shelf with this hemmed edge overhanging the front of the top hem. Now we want to take a top shelf end and put it on the range. With the arms facing to the right and this retainer facing straight up in the air on the right hand side. And slide that panel over the end of the assembly. We're going to take two sheet metal screws, and they're the ones with the pointed tip, and we're going to screw them into the deflector. It may be necessary to pull that deflector up in order to catch the hole. And assemble it into the Tinnerman clip. Once you have that side done, take a screwdriver and just tighten lightly. Just enough to hold it in place for now. Now we're going to do the same thing with the other end. With the legs pointing to the right, we're going to slip it over the opposite end, making sure that the top shelf end goes on the outside of this hemmed edge. Now that we have the other side in place, we're going to take a sheet metal screw with a nut, and we're going to pick up on the back of the deflector and put the sheet metal screw through the first hole on the right or the left side. And while holding the deflector up, screw a nut on the bottom side of that machine bolt. Just finger tight. Then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay, now we'll come back, we'll put the next one in, slowly bringing that deflector up as we go. And we're going to do the same thing for the next, for the remainder of the three screws. Okay, once we have all these machine screws in place, I've gone back and I've retightened each one of these screws on both sides. Now, it's not necessary to over-tighten them, so you just want to bring them up until they appear to be snug. Now we're going to take the top shelf and we're going to turn it over and stand it upright on the table. And we're going to take the two remaining sheet metal screws and string relief and put them in to the small diameter holes at the back of the top shelf. And it really doesn't make any difference which side the strain relief goes on. But you want to put it on one of the two sides, either the left or the right. Now, this can be used A as a ground,
or B, as just a strain release that you can attach to the back of a microwave, just in case you have a microwave on here and something happens and it gets pulled forward, it's not going to fall to the ground. Let's put the other one on the other side. And there you have it. Now that the top shelf is complete, you can install on the range. So we're going to take it over. Now, the range that you're going to use it on may have a short control panel, or it may have a tall control panel. What you want to do is you want to set the top shelf on the unit with this wide part going over the control panel and these legs coming out to the front on each side of the range. It's best to hook the opposite side on the back corner of your range, and then you'll have to pull the other side out and drop it down over the range. Slide it in place. These legs have a tendency to curve in. Just pull them out and drop them onto the rails of the side of the top. Push down to make sure that the resting points are all touching the range top. That makes it ready for you to put appliances on top of the shelf.